Thousands of crooks have falsely claimed to be flood victims in an attempt to swindle the New South Wales government out of almost $40 million. Fake images, bank statements and rentals documents were used in fraudulent applications, infuriating those who do need the cash and are struggling to get help.
As flood devastation swept across northern New South Wales, displaced locals were promised money fast. At the same time, people were trying to scam their way into grant programs, hoping to fill their pockets.
These are lowlife. They are absolute scum of the earth to really loot, essentially digitally loot, when people are really desperate.
Across the February to March grant programs, there were 3,600 cases of suspected fraud identified, more than $38 million in claims blocked. Photo matching technology found this flooded office is actually an airbase in Turkey. This one is in the US. This same image was submitted more than 30 times, and this one is computer generated, featuring a rubber duck.
To hear that kind of stuff just, yeah, makes you want to cry. It's like there's people out there genuinely begging for help.
Paul is still undertaking major renovations to his flood-impacted property. He found the grant applications too complex.
And they gave me a list of what they actually require, and it's probably about another 200 pages of information. I gave up, really.
There was also a 30% increase in the number of change of address requests after February's storms and floods. Applicants going to extreme lengths to falsely prove they live in flood-impacted towns.
Well, this is despicable behaviour. We think that there's more questions for the government to actually answer today to make sure that those appropriate checks are in place.
The government has flagged suspicious claims and referred them to police. It says the penalties should be enough of a deterrence. The maximum for fraud is 10 years in prison.
Karma's definitely going to get you, and hopefully the justice will kick you in the backside as well.
Sarah Navin for 10 News First.